The objective of this video is to provide medical personnel with the general recommendation for the use of an anesthesia device for long-term ventilation. Medical personnel to use the device should be instructed on its use and should be familiarized with the Dräger anesthesia device functionalities. An experienced anesthesia user should be at hand, like for example an anesthesiologist should be available 24/7. In the case of an emergency, please call for help in an early stage. Before connecting the patient, verify for the readiness of the systems and accessories. More details on how to do that will be explained later in this video. Make sure that an emergency resuscitator is always at hand. This is to make sure that ventilation is secure for the patient in the case of an emergency. For non-invasive ventilation, ICU mechanical ventilator or non-invasive ventilators should be preferred. Remove all vaporizers from the anesthesia device. The small amount of anesthetic agent might trigger malignant hyperthermia on the patient or on the clinical staff. To do so, press the button and turn the dial to the T transport position. Then turn the lever and take the vaporizer out. Please be aware that the vaporizer is heavy. Make sure nitrous oxide is not supplied to the anesthesia device. The recommendation is to take the hose out. To do so, please disconnect from the source and then from the anesthesia device. Keep in mind, manual spontaneous mode in the ICU ventilator does not equal the one in the anesthesia device. Use it only after instruction of an anesthesia expert. If your anesthesia device is supplied with external fresh gas outlet, our recommendation is not to use it for long-term ventilation. Keep in mind, in volume control ventilation, there is no automatic compensation of leakage. That's the reason why pressure control ventilation mode should we always prefer in the case of leakages. To do so, just select pressure control and confirm by the rotary knob. In the case of a situation of deficit of fresh gas flow, you have to act immediately. Either you have to identify and correct leakages, or you have to increase the fresh gas flow. Additionally, you can take out the manual breathing bag and allow the system to take ambient air into it. Keep in mind that in this situation, you will have the inspired fraction of oxygen between the set fraction of oxygen in the fresh gas flow and 21% from the ambient air. If possible, stay always in the vicinity of the anesthesia device. Remember, the design of the alarm management has been done for the operating theater, where the user is always close to it. When using the anesthesia device for long-term ventilation, our recommendation is to set the alarm volume to the maximum level. To do so, press the menu button, then access the alarm volume and take it to the maximum level using the rotary knob, and then confirm it. Keep in mind, the alarm management on the anesthesia device will automatically delete the display of the message when the situation triggering the alarm has disappeared. To verify if any alarm occurred in the absence of the user, you can access the alarm logbook. To do so, press the menu button and access the alarm log. Then you can scroll down to verify all alarms. It is necessary to frequently check on the soda lime condition. To do so, visually monitor the color change on the soda lime canister. You have to make sure that no more of two-thirds of its content has turned into color purple. Additionally, to verify in the change of color of the soda line, you have to monitor the inspired CO2. This level should not be above 5 milliliters of mercury. The procedure to exchange the saline canister is the following. First, press on the release button and slide the cartridge out. Then take a new cartridge and remove the cap. Then slide it in and close it. The gas measurement water trap is another element that should be frequently checked. To do so, visually inspect that its content of water has not reached more than 50% of its capacity. If that is not the case, you will have to drain it. To do so, first unplug the sample line. Then you will need to take the water trap out and use a regular syringe and put it on the lower collar port to drain it. You might need to repeat the process if there is still some water remaining inside of the water trap. Then you place the empty water trap back in the port. And you tightly secure the sample line. It is also recommended to frequently check on the breathing hose system. If possible, use a hose system with a water trap so you can drain it if condensed water is on it. You take the water trap and then you unplug it and drain it. Then you put it back on its place. In combination with the anesthesia device, it is recommended only to use mechanical filters. For long-term ventilation with the anesthesia device, it is recommended to use a mechanical filter in combination with HME for better passive humidification. In the case of the filter being too humid or soaking water, please replace it. The hospital guidelines with regards to infection prevention and control should always be followed. The gas measurement sample line should always be tightly connected to the water trap and to the patient filter, because it is through this system that we are measuring the CO2. In the case of the Inspire oxygen, it is measured by using this oxygen sensor. You have to constantly visually monitor the values of the FiO2 and CO2. Because of the rebreathing system, the measured values might differ slightly from the set ones. Be aware that the movement of the manual breathing bag will be in synchronization with the mechanical ventilation. Also, keep in mind that it should be always be full and evenly filled. Please remember that drug nebulization and aerosol therapy is not suitable for anesthesia devices. The self-test verification on the anesthesia device should be performed every 24 hours. Now, in the case of using the device for long-term ventilation, the minimum frequency is 7 to 2 hours. Keep in mind that the self-test on the anesthesia device, together with the verification of the system, will take around 8 minutes in total, depending on the model of the anesthesia device. During this time to ventilate the patient, you will require either an emergency resuscitator or an additional ventilation device. All the details on how to perform the verification on the system and the self-test will be explained in an additional video.